The state of single motherhood in Uganda is worrying, which is partly attributed to gender-based violence in families. Unfortunately, in such circumstances, women and children suffer the most. But why is the number of single mothers on the rise?
Some young girls going for married men. These married men deceive them that they don't have families. When he impregnates you and you give birth, that may mark the end of the relationship, simply because the man fears to lose his family. He's a committed person.
The press briefing, which was meant to highlight the plight of women, opened a Pandora's box. This was after Kilak South County Member of Parliament Gilbert Olanya held a differing view on the increase in the number of single mothers.
Other women who are fully empowered, those ones who are well off, they prefer living like single mothers. And the case in point, we have also in Parliament. In fact, every term, 10% of members of Parliament do leave their husbands. And we do not know why such things are happening. That's why we need to research on this, the relationship between well-to-do ladies and marriage.
You are the people who make advances to us. Sometimes you tell us lies. And it's not true, Honorable Gilbert, that 10%.
What I'm meaning,
to this, WOPA Chairperson Pamela Kamugo, Nasiyo pledged the association's commitment towards spearheading campaigns against single motherhood.
You men are responsible for these single mothers. If you love someone's daughter, you reassure them of your love, your care, your support. But in the middle of the relationship, you break away. You break away. Really, you are to blame. Men are to blame.
This affirmation comes at a time Uganda is joining the rest of the world to celebrate International Women's Day. To this effect, Speaker of Parliament Rebecca Kadaga has highlighted recent progress made by Parliament in highlighting the plight of women.
Last month, we granted leave to Honorable Ariko and two other colleagues to move a motion to enact a bill entitled the Anti-Slavery Bill 2018. This comes as a result of the numerous reports about trafficking and slavery of Ugandans, especially the women. So we have granted him leave, and then we are expecting the bill will be brought so that we can discuss it.
But as this is done, legislators want the recently refurbished Mlago Specialized Women's Hospital made free to fight maternal and child mortality.
As you recall, that is something that the women constituency lobbied for since the 7th Parliament. It was constructed, but what we have been discussing is how it is impacting the population and how inequality is affecting the women. So all those have been discussed.
Women go through a lot of traumatizing experiences, and therefore it's important that we as a country look at those intricacies that affect our women. And yet we know that any woman who has ascended into a public office actually has done a tremendous work.
International Women's Day is observed every 8th of March, with Uganda holding its celebrations in Bunyangabo district in the Western region. It will be held under the theme, Empowering Women Through Innovative Approaches to Social Protection, a prerequisite for inclusive and sustainable development. Henry Okrut, UBC.